Oh, hey guys, how you doing today? So everybody showed up here today because you want to know how to replace a screen, either a cell phone or computer or any type of screen really, right inside of your editor using CoreMelt's plugin TrackX. Well, stay tuned because I'm about to show you how to do that. If you guys could do me a big favor before we start, make sure to hit that thumbs up button, share these videos with your friends. If you haven't already, make sure you're subscribed. And if you are subscribed, make sure you hit that little bell so you get all the notifications when we post new videos or go live. Also, make sure to follow us on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, and LinkedIn so you can stay up to date with everything we're doing. So being able to replace a cell phone screen or computer screen inside a post is a very important thing to know how to do, especially for people like me who shoot a lot of TV commercials. And a lot of the times we have to put a website on a screen, but the website's not built yet, so we have to switch it out in post. And I don't want to have to jump into like After Effects, then render it out, and then bring it back into my editor. That's just way too much time. So I found a plugin by CoreMelt called TrackX that allows me to work right inside a Final Cut Pro X to replace my cell phone screen or computer screen right inside of it. Let me show you how it works right now. So the first thing we're going to do is take a look at the image that we want to replace the screen on. So as you can see, I have my cell phone sitting there on a table with my tracking image set up on it. So the next thing we're going to want to do is get the tracking plugin set up. So we're going to go up to the generator tab and we're going to choose track layer. We're going to drag that down onto our clip right above the clip that we want the tracker to work on. And then we're going to hit B to get our blade tool. We're going to hit A to get it back to our arrow tool. And we're just going to clean that up so our tracking layer image and our clip are the same length. Then we want to go to the first frame. So we're going to hit our up arrow to transport to the first frame. Then we're going to click on our polygon tool. And we're going to draw a shape around our tracking markers. Just like that. Then we're going to come down here to the little T and we're going to click that to track our image. Now this is going to take a minute, so I'll speed it up for you. So once you are done tracking the image, the next thing you're going to want to do is go to the viewer and click where it says surface. Now we need to insert a layer to be able to replace the current screen of our cell phone. So as you can see over here in my clips, I already have an image that I want to be able to replace my cell phone screen with. So I'm going to click on the image and drag it over to that little blue box. And now when you come back and click on the timeline, you will see that the image is now inserted into the video. To align our image to the screen, we're going to use these little handles right here to drag our image into the correct position. I will speed this process up so you guys can see the whole thing. Also note, sometimes it does help to zoom in so you can see exactly where you're positioning the image. Now that we have successfully positioned our image, all that's left to do is check out our final results. So guys, I highly recommend buying TrackX by CoreMelt. It is a great plugin that allows you to work right inside of your normal editor to be able to replace your cell phone screen or computer screen without having to go to any other software. If you're interested in buying it, I will put a link in the description below. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comment section. But remember, as usual, most importantly, dream big, think bigger, and always be you.